Hey learners, welcome back to my another video. This video is requested by one of our viewer whose name is Saksham, and the topic is consumer behavior model. So let's start today's video. Consumer behavior models have been developed to identify various factors that influence consumer behavior and their decision making process. And in this video, we will see those models. There are two most common models, one traditional model and second contemporary models. In traditional model we have economic model, learning model, psychoanalytical model, sociological model, whereas in contemporary model we have Howard Seth model, Nicosia, stimulus response model, Engel, Blackwell and Minard model. Now let us see all these models in detail. First we will see traditional model. In traditional model, first we have economic model. This model focuses on act of purchase of an average consumer, which say what a consumer would purchase and in what quantity. According to this model, a consumer will buy different quantity of product according to their prices. For instance, a consumer will buy a similar product that is being offered at lower price to maximize the benefits. An increase in consumer's purchasing power will allow him to increase the quantity of the products that he is purchasing. If he has more money, he will buy more quantity. If he has less money, he will buy less quantity of that product. Second, we have learning model. This model is based on the idea that consumer behavior is governed by the need to satisfy basic and learned needs. Basic need here is food, clothing, and shelter, while learned need include fear and guilt. Thus, a consumer will have a tendency to buy things to satisfy their needs and to provide maximum satisfaction to themselves. For example, a hungry customer may not buy jewelries or any accessories when he is hungry. If he has money, he will go to buy food rather than buying jewelries or housing or clothing. But if he have enough money apart from food, then he can think of buying jewelry or he can think of buying other things. But first, the need is here food, so he will definitely go for buying a food instead of buying any other thing. The third model we have, psychoanalytical model. The psychoanalytical model takes into consideration the fact that consumer is influenced by both the conscious and subconscious mind. The three levels of consciousness are ID, ego and superego. All work to influence one's buying decisions and behavior. Here, ID is what an individual is born with. Superego are formed out of values. Ego acts as a balance between ID and superego. For example, in today's market, there are a number of fake products which are a true copy of original brand. And if we take the example of L'Oreal, suppose they are a true copy of L'Oreal in the market. Almost everything is same, packaging, color, texture, everything is same. Only a little slightly change in the logo, or a slightly, you can say one spell is missing on that brand name. But customer's subconscious mind believe that even the product is fake, they believe it's real one and they buy it because maybe they are not like aware of that, or they are in hurry, or they don't know, or they and their eyes couldn't find that mistake, but they believe and they buy that. So here this model tell us about that thing. Next model we have sociological model. Sociological model of consumer behavior is closely related to the term society. This model says A consumer behavior is moreover influenced by society. Here, there's two type of groups which influence the buying behavior of consumer. They are primary and secondary group. In primary group, members are moreover friends, relative, and family members. Whereas in secondary group, members are society, personality type, and requirements based on same. Sociological model focus mainly on the lifestyle and related product requirements of consumer in the society. Now, after completing traditional model, the next we have contemporary models. In contemporary model, the first we have Howard Seth model. This model provides information regarding complexity involved in consumer behavior, and it considered various factors like attitudes of consumer, their perception level, and learning capacity that influence consumer behavior. This model is based on four variables, such as input variables, output variables, hypothetical constructs, which is also represented as perceptual constructs and learning constructs. And last, exogenous variables. Now let us see all these variables. As per Howard Seth model, inputs are provided by three types of stimuli, such as significative stimuli, symbolic stimuli, and social stimuli that are essential to make a purchasing decision. Here, significative stimuli refers to the tangible product characteristics like uniqueness, quality, stock availability, price, and service effectiveness. Whereas, symbolic stimuli refers to perception of an individual about a particular product characteristics. Whereas, social stimuli focuses on all the factors that belong to societal groups to which a consumer belongs. Some factors related to social stimuli are reference groups, family, and background, and consumers' financial status in the society. Output. Output in Howard Seth model refers to the final purchase decision and satisfaction or dissatisfaction level of a customer after making a purchase. High satisfaction results in elevated brand performance, while dissatisfaction leads to lower brand performance. Hypothetical construct include the psychological variables influencing consumer behavior during the decision-making process. Here, hypothetical constructs have been classified into two groups, perceptual constructs and learning constructs. The first, which is perceptual constructs, deals with the way the individual perceived and responds to the information, whereas learning construct deals with how buyer forms attitudes, opinions, and knowledge influencing his buying decisions and also in evaluation after purchase. Last variable we have exogenous variables, which is also called external variables, which refers to the indirect influence exerted on decision-making process of consumers by factors such as financial status, social class, necessity to purchase, and personality traits of individual. Next model we have Engel-Kollat Blackwell model. This model is essentially a conscious problem-solving and learning model of consumer behavior. This model has a good description of active information seeking and evaluation process of consumer, which reflect consumer behavior process during choosing product or services. In this model of consumer behavior, they view consumer behavior as a decision process and identify four different activities occurring in this decision-making process, which are problem recognition or need recognition, information search, evaluation of alternatives, and choice. Here, in problem recognition, they compare their actual state and ideal state. Whereas, in information search, they try to gather more information from various sources. In alternative evaluation, individuals will evaluate alternate brands. The method used for evaluating the various products will depend on consumers' underlying goals, motives, and personality. Choice. Here, the consumer's choice will depend on his or her intention and attitudes. Outcome. The outcome may be either positive or negative as per the information provided to them or as per their past experiences. Next model we have Negocia model. This model shows the interactive relationship between company and the consumer. Here, they form a mutual communication between company and customer. Company communicates with consumer through promotional activities, while consumer by making purchase. In Negocia model, the decision-making process is divided into four areas. First, consumer attitudes. Consumer attitudes is shaped by information from the market. In this area, information flows from company to customer. Second, research and evaluation. In this area, consumer is looking for information related to the product. During the evaluation, a consumer allocates appropriate information about the product. When the result of evaluation of a given product from the consumer point of view is satisfied, then consumer is motivated to buy that product. Third area is act of purchase. After evaluation and analysis, when customer is fully satisfied with the product, then they are motivated to buy that product. And here, they just purchase the product and they use it. Last area we have feedback. Feedback is a form of response which comes after consuming the product. It can be either positive or negative. Now, the last model we have, stimulus response model. Marketing and other stimuli enter the buyer's black box or buyer's mind and produces certain choice or purchase responses. Marketers must figure out what is inside the buyer's black box and how stimuli are changed to responses. Marketing stimuli consist of 4 P's: product, price, place, and promotion. Other stimuli include major forces and events in buyer's environment, like economic, technology, political, and cultural. All these inputs plays a very important role in impacting buyer's responses, which can be product choice, brand choice, dealer choice, purchase timing, and purchase amount. The marketer wants to understand how the stimuli are changed into responses inside the customer's black box, which has 2 parts. First, the buyer's characteristic influence how he or she perceives and reacts to the stimuli, and second, the buyer's decision process itself affects the buyer's behavior. So with this, we have completed our another video, which is on consumer behavior model. I hope you liked the video. If yes, then don't forget to give a thumb up and subscribe my channel to get notified with my latest update. See you soon with some more interesting topics. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.